गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल अगेन कंटिन्यू आवर सिक्स्थ चैप्टर फ्रॉम द केन फिलोसॉफी. इन द लास्ट चैप्टर वी हैव आई हैव सेइंग टू यू द टू पार्ट्स, द सिक्स्थ पार्ट वन एंड द सिक्स्थ पार्ट टू. सो लेट अस रिवाइज सम पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम दैट सिक्स्थ. द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज द सिक्स्थ. इट इज फ्रॉम द डॉक्टर केन्स lecture on homeopathic philosophy. Previously only I have told you ki these are the lectures, these are not a book which is written by Dr. Kane. The chapters which are included here these are the lectures which were given by Dr. Kane to his followers. Some lectures were given to the allopathic physician because they are always opposing us. They causes obstruction for the homeopathy, and that's why the some lectures he had delivered to his followers, to his students, and the some lectures are in this book. They are delivered to the allopathic physicians, and hence it is in the form of essay. Or they are very long, as it is a philosophy, so it is very long. The same point he has described in the many ways. So let us start. We will just take a small summary of the points that we have covered in the first last lecture in the two parts. So summary is that who is the sick person? The sick person is who is having a disease. What is disease? Manifestations of the disease are nothing but the signs and symptoms, or we can say that signs and symptoms are nothing but the manifestation of the disease. So Hahnemann once said that there are no diseases but sick people. One second. So from which it is clear that the Hahnemann understood the disease is what? It is not the bright disease, it is not the liver disease where the gross forms of disease results appears. They are only the appearance of diseases. Then what is the disease? The disease means the derangement of vital force. The sick will be made sick under every circumstances where the healthy man could live in the lesser two. So whenever that person is feeling the discomfortness, or he is away from the ease, that is the sick. The sickness can be learned by the study of proving the drugs on the healthy human being that we have seen in the drug proving in the first year. So Hahnemann made use this information and obtained the symptoms of the mind. So who is the sick? The person who is having the sign and symptoms, though we are not able to diagnose that person, though the pathological findings are physiological, they are within the normal range, but if that person is not feeling well, then he is the sick person. What the allopathic physicians are doing, they want the pathological reports, they should be beyond the normal range. Then only that person is sick. Then they are not having the fixed principles. They are having the shifting methods and shifting theories. The discoveries they are doing very rapidly without any concrete base that we have seen. On the other hand, the homeopathy is a form. It is having the fixed principle. They are treating the patient with the knife, with the surgery, that is the abscard, and it is the amenable to that patient. So what they feel about the disease, where they can feel with the finger, where they can see with the eye, and they can observe with the instruments. But without all these things, if that patient is having the signs and symptoms, then that patient is sick, that we are considering. We are not taking the help of microscope. We are not taking the help of pathological results. This is important to us to know only the diagnosis. We are not doing the prescription on the basis of this diagnosis. The results which we are getting from the pathological testing, that we will confirm it only for the prognosis, but we are not doing the prescription on the basis of that pathological result. But on in the allopathy, they are doing the prescription on the basis of this pathological result. So this is the way of treating the allopathy to the patient. Then in the very first aphorism, Dr. Hanuman has explained clearly who is the sick and what is the mission of the physician. That also we have considered. Then after that, we have also considered the certain sentences that are very much important. What is that? The true homeopath, when speak about the sick, know who it is the sick, whereas the allopath does not know. So sick means a homeopath know. He, those are having the sign and symptom, he is the sick. उसके pathological studies कैसे भी आए, but he is the sick. Then we have seen the doctrine of vital force, the importance of vital force in our body. If the vital force is present, then the harmony is maintained in our body. The organs and the systems are working properly. There is a relation between the cause and effect. But if you are not giving the importance to the doctrine of vital force, then you will not have any understanding, or you will not understand what is the cause and what is the effect, and you will treat that particular affected part as a person. The holistic concept will not be there if you are not understanding the doctrine of vital force, which is said by Dr. Kane. Then second thing is that he used the word simple substance for the vital force. Again, he has explained who is the sick, though he is having the all pathological tests are negative. So he has given the example, very nice example here, ki chest examination, neurologist, cardiac specialist, eye specialist, gynecologist, physical examination, all the things are normal, but still that person is having the certain symptom, and that symptom is constipation. And for the constipation, he has done these much examination, but all the examinations are within the normal range. They are physiological, so it is very difficult to do the diagnosis to that allopathic physician. That is the first thing that have been diagnosed. तो उनको diagnosis नहीं मिला, so they cannot prescribe the medicine. लेकिन वही केस अगर होम्योपैथ के पास आएगी, so he will know the doctrine of vital force. He will find out the cause. Then he will find out the effect. So what will be the effect of that constipation? It may lead to the hemorrhoids, it may be the bleeding, it may be the non-bleeding, and he will prescribe only on the basis of this symptom. He will not again ask that patient to do the pathological investigation. So this is the first example, and he said that a very much important line here: these symptoms are but the language of nature, talking out as it were and showing as clearly as a daylight the internal nature of the sick man. So this line very clear that the symptoms are nothing but the language of disease, and they are as much as clear as that of the daylight. There is no second option is required for the prescription. We do not require the diagnosis for the prescription. We require diagnosis for the prognosis of that patient. Second example he has given about the tuberculosis. Here he used the word consumption for the tuberculosis. If that patient is having the tuberculosis, then he can do the prescription very easily. लेकिन उसके पहले अगर उसको सर्दी खांसी है, so he always want fever, because fever is the indication of infection. So if the fever is there, then he can easily prescribe the antibiotic, and it is very easy to do the prescription for that allopathic physician. But we can do the easy prescription on the basis of mycorrhiza. We don't require the fever. And if that person is having the tuberculosis, then it is very, very, very easiest case for that allopathic physician. Directly he will give the AQT. He will start the anti-tubercular drug. So he will, but for that he again want the certain pathological investigation to confirm that AKT or to confirm that tuberculosis, or he can confirm that bright disease. The albumin is, if it is present in the urine, then it is very easy for him to diagnose, and most important is to do the prescription. But on the basis of sign and symptoms only we are doing the prescription. That is again a basic difference between the prescription of allopathy and this between the prescription of the homeopathy. Further, he has given the third example of the nervous child, that he is restless, excitement, he is having the hysterical manifestation. Here also he required the explanation from the neurologist. He also want the diagnosis, and then only the homeopathic physician can do the prescription. So here a very good line given by Dr. Kane. He said that on the basis of above examples, he said that the tissues could not become sick unless something prior to them had been deranged and so make them sick. So this is a very good line related to the above three examples. उन्होंने कहा है कि tissues could not become sick. Tissue अपने मन से कुछ भी नहीं करेगा. कब तक क्यों नहीं करेगा? क्योंकि उसको संभालने वाला एक है. That internal authority is present inside the body, and that internal authority is a simple substance or the vital force. So before that tissue, तो वो टिश्यू कब तक सीख नहीं होगा? Unless something prior to them, उसके पहले कुछ तो भी had been deranged. तो उसके पहले क्या है? तो simple substance and vital force. When it is get deranged, then only that person became a sick. Then he has again asked the question, who is the internal man? So internal man is nothing but the vital force. कि वो anatomist को भी नहीं मिलेगा when you are doing the dissection of the body. Even when we are doing the PM, there also you will not get the existence of that vital force. Why? Because the vital force will not be present in that dead body. The real sick man is prior to the sick body. So that vital force here, the real sick man is the prior to the sick body. And jo vital, ye sick kab hoga? Whenever there is a derangement of vital force. So sick body se pehle ye derangement hoga. That vital force becomes sick, and then it is manifested on the external part of the body in the form of sick body. We must conclude that the sick man somewhere in the portion which is not left behind. So iske pehle vital force derange hoga, and then there is a sick man that we have seen. Then the jo abhi apne ko dikh raha hai, which we can feel, we can see, we can taste, we can think, this is all the ultimates. Iske ultimates hai ye the derangement of the vital force ke. Then he has explained about the will and understanding. Up till now we have completed in the previous part. Now we will take the second part of this chapter, which is very nicely explained by Dr. Kane, that is the will and understanding. So Dr. Kane has given the more importance to the mentors. Whenever you will do the totality in the repertory subject in the faculty, you will learn how to make the totality according to the different authors. So if you are doing the totality according to the Dr. Kane, so you have to give the preference to the mental symptoms. कि ऐसे भी बोल सकते हैं कि इफ योर केस, इफ योर पेशेंट इज हैविंग द मोर नंबर ऑफ मेंटल सिम्टम्स, देन यू हैव टू प्रिफर द रेपर्टरी ऑफ केन. या फिर आपने केन के टोटालिटी के हिसाब से आपने वो टोटालिटी ऑफ सिम्टम्स बनानी है. तो व्हाट इज द प्रेफरेंस गिवन और द हायरार्की क्या है केन की? द मेंटल सिम्टम्स शुड बी फर्स्ट, एंड इन दैट मेंटल सिम्टम द थ्री सब पार्ट्स आर देयर, विल, understanding and his intelligence. So these teen ke basis pe you can take the symptoms or you can take the mental history of that patient. Then second is the physical general, and the third one is the pathological. So this is the hierarchy if you are doing the totality according to Dr. Kane. So you will learn in the repertory subject ki how the totalities differ according to the viewpoint of that philosopher, according to that pioneer. Hahnemann ki totality alag hai, Kane ki alag hai, Stuart Close ki alag hai, H.R. Robert ki alag hai, Boni Hussein ki aur alag hai. So we will learn these totality in the third year or in the fourth year in the repetitive subject. So here we will stick to the Kane's philosophy or the Kane totality. तो यहाँ पे उन्होंने किसको importance दिया है? Mental symptoms को. And the mental symptoms में he has given the 3 points that again you have to give me on the group कि which 3 points are more important while making the totality of by the Kane. That I have told you previously, you just listen it carefully, you will get these 3 points. You have to answer me. When you will give the answer, then only I will give the attendance. Okay? So again, I am repeating the question. Which 3 points are important in while you are taking the mental symptoms of the patient? Okay. Now we will move further. So the will and understanding that are important in the healthy man, and that will and understanding that you will get only in the living person. You will not get it in the cadaver. It is not our purpose to go behind the will and understanding to go prior to this. So उन्होंने फिर से कहा है कि will and understanding किसके वजह से है. So it is only because of that vital force. अगर वाइटल फोर्स नहीं है तो कैडावर को विल एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं रहेगा. सो वो समझ रहा है, उसके कुछ इच्छाएं हैं. सो दीज आर ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ द दैट प्रायर मैन, दैट इंटरनल मैन, दैट सिंपल सब्सटेंस. इट इज इनफ टू से दैट दे वेर क्रिएटेड. सो दे आर क्रिएटेड बाय हूम? दे आर क्रिएटेड बाय सिंपल सब्सटेंस. द मैन is the will and understanding, and the house which he uses his body. Very nice sentence given by Dr. Kane. इतना easy है ये sentence कि इस पर से हमको समझ जाता है कि this is nothing but the vital force. So who is maintaining our will and understanding? The simple substance. And where he lives? He lives in the body, and that's why that body is a living one. Otherwise, that is a cadaver. We must, to be a scientific homeopath, recognizes that muscle, the nerves, the ligament, and the other parts of the man's frame and are picture and manifest to intelligent physician as the internal man. So hamare jo muscles hai, jo nerves hai, ligaments hai, and the other parts of our body, they are working only by this internal man. So ye humko pata hai, and that's why we are the intelligent homeopathic physician. Both the dead and the living body are to be considered not from the body of life but from the life to the body. A very much important sentence is this ki from the life to the body. Agar vital force hai, then that body is having the importance. Then that body, we called it a name is to that body XYZ. If that vital force is not there, then there is no importance to that body. The body is of no importance, no intelligence, no will, no understanding. If we are describe the difference between the two human faces, their character and everything we observe of their action, you would be describing scarcely more than the will. So if you are comparing the two faces, their will, their understanding are different because human beings are different from each other. The will express the face, its results is implanted on the countenance. Have you ever studied the face of individual who has grown up a murderer or a villain of some sort? So here he explained the will and understanding very nicely. Suppose you are, I am taking a good example here. You are not the exam going students, right? But your colleagues, they are the exam going. So you do one thing, you just do a video call to them, 2 to 3 students who are the favorite to you, and just observe their expressions. You just unko question pooch lo ki what about your examination, and just inquire them what about the date of your examination, how you are planning to go to the examination center, ya college se hi de rahe ho. You just ask them, so what will be their expressions? Yes, they will become a sad. और वही expressions आपके कैसे रहेंगे? You आपको भी ठीक है, बुरा लगेगा, लेकिन you will not in that stage. You are neutral रहेगा, ठीक है, इनके exam हो ना हो, हमारी तो पढ़ाई चालू है, हमारा तो online सब कुछ चालू है, मैम तो हमको बोर कर ही रहे हैं by the online. So at that time just compare your face and their faces. सो देयर विल इज व्हाट कि एग्जामिनेशन ना हो, हम लोग ये झंझट से छूट जाए. सो दैट विल बी रिफ्लेक्टेड ऑन देयर फेस. तो उनके फेस के एक्सप्रेशंस और आपके फेस के एक्सप्रेशंस, तो आपके आपके दिमाग में क्या चल रहा होगा कि उनसे आंसर क्या आएगा. यू विल बी अ वेरी क्यूरियस, या फिर ठीक है बाबा हमारा तो कुछ नहीं है, सो वी आर द न्यूट्रल. सो सम सॉर्ट्स ऑफ ये सॉर्ट के एक्सप्रेशंस आपके फेस पे रहेंगे और उनके फेस पे रहेंगे स्लाइट एंजाइटी, स्लाइट वरी, और आपके इसमें न्यूट्रल एक्सप्रेशंस या हैप्पी एक्सप्रेशंस. सो योर थिंकिंग, योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, योर विल एक्सप्रेस ऑन योर फेस. समझ रहा है? आर यू गेटिंग द थिंग्स? सो आपके जो एक्सप्रेशंस रहेंगे वो थोड़े हैप्पी रहेंगे. हम उसको एक वर्ड नेम कलेक्टिव टर्म यूज करेंगे हैप्पी, और उनका एक कलेक्टिव वर्ड यूज करेंगे अनहैप्पी, सॉर्ट ऑफ एंशियस. सो जो आप सोच रहे हो, जो आपके अंडरस्टैंडिंग है, वैसे ही आपके फेस पे वो एक्सप्रेस होगा. इफ यू आर हैप्पी देन यू विल स्माइल ऑल द डे. इफ यू आर अनहैप्पी, यू आर सैड, तो आप एक जगह पे जाके बैठ जाएंगे और थोड़ा सा चेहरा आपका मुरझाया हुआ लगेगा. सो जो आप सोचते हो, जो आप महसूस करते हो, सो डायरेक्टली इट विल एक्सप्रेस ऑन योर फेस. दैट इज एक्सप्लेन वेरी नाइसली हियर. सो ही हैज गिवन द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ मर्डरर एंड विलन. तो उनके फेस अलग रहते हैं एज कम्पेयर टू द इनोसेंट पर्सन. सो ये यू कैन ऑब्जर्व इट ऑन द पिक्चर्स. अभी तो आप बहुत सारी मूवीज देख रहे होंगे, तो उस पर से आप कर सकते हो कि हाँ ही इज द हीरो एंड ही इज द विलन, बिकॉज दैट विलन इज हैविंग द सर्टन बैड थॉट्स एंड दैट हीरो इज हैविंग द गुड थॉट्स टू डांस विद द हीरोइन. सो दीज आर द फेशियल एक्सप्रेशंस दैट यू कैन इजिली कंपेयर. सो बाय विच यू कैन इजिली कंपेयर द विल एंड द अंडरस्टैंडिंग बिटवीन द टू पर्सन. Is there no difference between his face and that one who has will to do good, to live uprightly? So, एक का क्या काम है? अच्छा अच्छा सोचना, अच्छा कुछ करना. और villain का काम क्या है? सब बुरा सोचना. So that they can do the destruction. Go down to the lower part of the great city and study the faces of these people. मैंने जो अभी बोला वही इन्होंने दिया है कि सबसे अच्छा अगर आपको फेस रीडिंग करना है तो आप फेस रीडिंग कौन सी जगह पे कर सकते हो? गिव मी द सम फ्यू प्लेसेस वेयर यू कैन रीड द पर्सन फेस वेरी नाइसली. नाउअडेज वी कैन नॉट डू इट बिकॉज ऑल द पीपल आर वेयरिंग द मास्क. सो हियर वी कैन रीड द आईज ऑफ दैट पर्सन, बट डोंट डू दैट. बट गिव मी द सम गुड प्लेसेस वेयर पहले आप कर सकते थे और आप बाद में कर सकोगे, लेकिन अभी आप नहीं करोगे. सो बिफोर एंड आफ्टर की जो कुछ मुझे ऐसे प्लेसेस बताओ कि वेयर यू कैन डू अ गुड फेस रीडिंग एक्टिविटी. सो दिस इज योर सेकंड क्वेश्चन कि वेयर यू विल गेट और यू विल गेट नॉलेज हाउ टू रीड दैट फेस, हाउ टू वी कैन जज द बॉडी लैंग्वेज ऑफ दैट पर्सन. मुझे ऐसे प्लेसेस बताने हैं, नॉट नाउ, इसके पहले आप कर सकते थे या इसके बाद में आप कर सकोगे, बिकॉज दिस स्टेज इज रिलेटेड टू द कोविड. सो कोविड जाने के बाद आप कहाँ पे कर सकोगे फेस रीडिंग अच्छे से? सो दिस इज योर सेकंड क्वेश्चन दैट हैव टू आंसर मी, अदरवाइज आई विल नॉट गिव यू अटेंडेंस. दीज पीपल आर द नाइट क्रॉलर्स, आर दे आर द टीप लेट एट द नाइट एंड स्टडिंग विलन. सो जो विलन रहते हैं दे आर एक्टिव मोर एट द नाइट. आई डोंट नो व्हाई. सो ही सेड दैट कि उनका फेस और जो सोरिक पेशेंट का फेस रहेगा इट इज टोटली डिफरेंट. दे हैव द स्टैम्प ऑन देयर फेसेस, क्रुएलिटी का उनपे स्टैम्प रहेगा. दे हैव द इवल एक्सप्रेशन एंड इवल फेस. द काउंटेनेंस देन द एक्सप्रेसिव ऑफ द हार्ट. उनका हार्ट भी हमेशा बुरी चीजें ही सोचेगा या बुरी चीजें ही करने के लिए कहेगा. द एलोपैथिक पैथोलॉजी रिकॉग्नाइजेज नथिंग बट द मैन्स बॉडी. They are not considering the doctrine of vital force. They are considering the expression only. लेकिन वो expression क्यों आ रहे हैं? ये वो नहीं सोच रहे हैं. Yet one can easily confuse the allopath by asking him what man's thought is, what man is. तो वो क्या करते हैं? वो उनका thought नहीं देख रहे हैं. तो वो क्या देख रहे हैं? सिर्फ who is the man? He is a scoundrel. He is a murderer. They will only think that. लेकिन उसके पीछे का जो thought है, why he is like that why he are having the such symptoms, he will not think that, because they are not accepting the doctrine of vital force. They are not accepting the will and understanding. The homeopath must master this thing before he can pursue the nature of the cause of the disease and before he can understand what is the cure. So homeopath ne kya karna chahiye, so he should know the cause of the disease. Wo villain bana hai to wo villain kyu bana hai, why is having the bad thoughts, why he is always anxious, why he always irritable, why he always have the destructive mind. Psychotic or syphilic jo phase hai wo sora se hi aaye hue hai. So why that psoriatic patient is converted into the psychosis, or why he is converted into the syphilitic nature, we have to find out that cause before the cure. To understand, we have to understand the history before the cure. It is a sole duty of the physician to heal the sick. So apne ko apni duty pata hai to heal that sick person, and hence we should understand the nature of the cause, the nature of that disease. It is not the sole duty to heal the results of sickness. This is again a very much important. Humko ultimate treat nahi karne hai. We have to treat that sick person. We have to treat the cause of that disease. But the sickness itself, when the man himself has been restored to health, and where the man to be restored harmony in tissues and in activity. So this is our aim. This is our sole duty. We are not treating the results of sickness, but what we are treating, we want to treat that sick person. And by treating that, what is our aim? To restore the harmony in the tissues and their activities. Then the sole duty of physician to put in order the interior of the economy, that is the will and understanding conjointly. So apni duty kya hai? To restore the harmony in the tissues, harmony in the activity. With that, put in order the interior economy, yani apna will aur apna understanding fir se acche se ho jaye. For example, if you are having a fever, with that you are having the cough and coryza. Suppose you are these are the symptoms. So according to the allopathy, you are having the pharyngitis. But what we are homeopathic physician, I am interested in the modalities. Ki what modalities you are having? Whether you are having a pain in the throat during the deglutition of water, during the deglutition of the solid food. If you are having the fever, what is the time modality? What is the postural modality? What is the seasonal modality of your fever? What is the concomitant? So I will be interested in that type of symptoms. And the most important is the cause of that sickness, the cause of that pharyngitis. Once I get all these things, and the second thing that I want to know, that your will and understanding during that phase of the disease, what you are thinking about that acute disease. If you are thinking that it is a cancerous and I will die, then it will be a different rubric for that. If you are saying that ha ye to hota hi rehta hai, chalta hi rehta hai, then there will be a different rubric. So again, I will take your will and your understanding, or that patient's understanding during the phase of the disease. So all these things I will collect, I will make the totality, and I will prescribe on it. Mujhe wo pharyngitis se kuch bhi lena dena nahi hai. So what I am doing here, I am not treating the results, I am not treating the pathological condition, I am not interested in the diagnosis of that patient. Yes, I am interested in the diagnosis only for the prognosis, not for the prescription. To main kis mein interested hu? The cause of the disease. Okay, then the tissues jo derange hue hai, jo activities uski thum gayi hai, jo uski will hai at this time, and jo uski understanding hai. On this point only I will do the prescription. Then what is my aim? To restore the harmony in tissues and to get his will and understanding back, ya taki wo acche tarah se soch sake. He will not having the fever, he should not have any anxiety about the that disease. So the tissue, kyunki tissue changes are not the body, they are only the results of disease. So जो टिश्यू जो चेंज हुए हैं, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द डिरेंजमेंट ऑफ द वाइटल फोर्स. और जो अपने को दिख रहा है, दैट इज द रिजल्ट. सो आप वाइटल फोर्स पे ही ऐसी मेडिसिन दो कि जो वाइटल फोर्स पे एक्ट करे, वो एक बार ठीक हो जाएगा तो अल्टीमेटली दैट डिसीज विल गेट क्योर. they are not the diseases. The Hanumans once said, there are no diseases, only the sick man. From which it is clear, the Hanuman understood that the disease, so-called bright disease, liver disease, etc. But the grosser forms of diseases results, namely the appearance of diseases. So, आपको उसके पहले कुछ तो भी problem है, and that's why they are appearing. So, treat the cause, the ultimate will be treated at the last. There is a first disorder in the government. So, what is the proper way? और ये क्या है? The procedure क्या है? Disease हुआ कैसे है? So, first disorder कहाँ पे है? Government में. Government यानी vital force में. Then it is proceeds to within outward. So this is yet the range. इधर से आपने यहाँ पे भी if the मोदी जी wants to take the lockdown decision. So lockdown के पहले ये lockdown करना है. So ये lockdown का जो ये है decision है वो किसने लिया? मोदी जी ने लिया. किसको दिया? Yes, उद्धव ठाकरे को. And then he will implement it on the on the population, यानी हम पे वो implement कर रहे हैं. So government पे पहले decision होगा, the government पे disturb first, then it will be proceed to the central government से या आ गया state government में, and then state government से वो आ गया जनता में, यानी हमारे इसमें आ गया. So the first disturbance or the first decision will taken by the government, and then it is proceeds outward to a that lockdown will be implemented to us. So ये within outward आ गया. Okay, so कहाँ पे disturbance है? पहले internal या internal man या vital force पे disturbance है, and then it is reflected outward. So reflected outward कैसा होगा? In the form of pathological changes in the tissue. तो आप अगर आपको lockdown खत्म करना है, so what you will do? You will quarrel within yourself? No. What you have to do? Again, you have to maintain the hierarchy. So from the pathological changes, you have to go to the state government, and from state government, you have to go to the central government. So in this way, the cure करने के लिए आपको कहाँ पे जाना पड़ेगा? आपको ये lockdown खत्म करना है तो to the central government ये आपकी बात माननी चाहिए. So you have to treat this vital force. Central government यानी हो गया vital force. Once you treat this, एक बार you know इनसे positive reply आ गया, then you will be in the unlock position. Clear? So treat this tissue changes. You have to give the dynamic medicine to this vital force. It will proceed and it will ultimately cure this pathological changes. In the practice of the today's medicine, the idea of government is not formed. Allopathy may, because they are not accepting doctrine of vital force. The tissue changes are only taken into the account. So they are not giving the importance to the central government. They are focusing only on the population, only on the people, and that's why they are not getting the result. He who considered the disease result to be disease itself, except to do away these diseases in incense. So they are not the proper way of treatment. The bacteria are the result of disease. ये हमारा पहले भी discuss हो गया है कि they are giving the more importance to the bacteria. But in the reality, bacteria are the ultimates. In the course of time, we will able to show perfectly that microscopical little failures are not the disease cause, but they are come after. They are the scavengers accompanying the disease, and that they are perfectly harmless in every respect. So, उन्होंने क्या कहा है bacteria को? They are the microscopical little fellows. They will not do to you anything. जब तक आपका जबकि आप immunity आपकी कम नहीं होती है, जब उसको opportunity मिलेगी, then only they will attack. So these are the scavengers. Scavenger वो कब बनेंगे? जब your vital force is deranged. तब तक वो कैसे है? They are perfectly harmless. Because so many bacteria are present in our intestine. So many bacteria are present in the air, in the water, in the soil, in your body, on your skin. कितने तो भी bacteria, कितने तो भी viruses are present in your body. But every time they are not acting because your immunity, your susceptibility is there, your vital force is there to protect your body, to protect you फ्रॉम दिस स्कैवेंजर्स. सो ये लिटिल फेलो से आपको बचा रहे हैं, लेकिन वो स्कैवेंजर कब बनेंगे, जब आपकी आर्मी is not working properly. When your vital forces deranged, then only these fellows became a scavenger. So what they are the ultimates. They are the outcome of disease. They are present wherever the disease is. They are the microscopy. It has been discovered. Every pathological lizard has its corresponding bacteria. We are also giving the importance to the bacteria. We are also saying that the pathological results are corresponding to the bacteria or any microbiological fellow or the parasite or the viruses. Lekin wo kab scavengers banenge, jab aapka vital force derange hoga, aapki defense power theek nahi hogi tab. The old school consider these the cause, but will be able to show the disease cause, which is more subtle than anything that can be shown by microscope. तो उनको तो आदत ही है. They always give the importance to the material things. They say that कि this pharyngitis is occur because of this staphylococcus, streptococci bacteria. We are having the proof, and that's why our theory is a rational theory of treating patient. Our science is a rational science because we are having a proof. What we are seeing, yes, bacteria are responsible for the disease. लेकिन वो bacteria के पहले जो कुछ है वो है vital force. वो derange है, इसलिए आपका bacteria वहाँ पे act कर रहा है. That's why that person is having the pharyngitis. So we are giving the importance to the staphylococci and streptococci. We are also giving the importance to the result of disease. लेकिन ये दोनों के पहले भी हम लोग central government को importance दे रहे हैं. We be able to show you the process of reasoning step by step. The folly of hunting the disease caused by implements the sentence. In the note, the Hahnemann says the physician is not, however, to construct the so-called system by interweaving the empty speculations and hypotheses concerning the internal essence of the nature of the vital processes and the mode of the disease originate in the invisible interior of the organism. So, उन्होंने कहा है कि एलोपैथी वाले जो अननेसेसरी उसको इम्पोर्टेंस दे रहे हैं, दे जो आप उनका डिसीज या उनकी जो सिस्टम जो कंस्ट्रक्ट कर रहे हैं, दे आर ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एम्प्टी स्पेकुलेशंस. दे आर ऑल द हाइपोथेसिस. दे आर नॉट गिविंग द इम्पोर्टेंस टू द इंटरनल नेचर ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स एंड हेंस दिस शुड नॉट बी द मिशन ऑफ द फिजिशियन. वी वॉन्ट know that in the present day the people are perfectly satisfied if they can find the name of disease. They are supposed to have an idea of clock to some wonderful technicity. So this is a very good sentence that we are also applying here. Nowadays when the patient comes to you, if he is having the symptom like body ache, like bony pain, then the some discomfortness, then some pain in the eyes, then he will put all the symptoms on the Google, and the Google guru will give the diagnosis, and he will say that ki mujhe thyroid ka problem to nahi hai because mera wazan bahut kam ho raha hai ya mera wazan bahut badh raha hai and I am having the bony pain and I cannot sleep. Directly he will ask you ki mujhe ye to nahi hai, because the people are more interested in the name of the disease. कि वही आदत एलोपैथी वालों ने डाली है कि आपको फेरेंजाइटिस है तो आपको ये एंटीबायोटिक लेनी पड़ेगी, आपको कोविड है तो आपको असाइक्लोविर लेनी पड़ेगी, आपको एक्सिक्यू लेना पड़ेगा, आपको स्वाइन फ्लू है तो आपको ये मेडिसिन. सो दे हैव एन हैबिट टू गिव द नेम गिविंग सेरेमनी, उनको बहुत अच्छी लगती है. और लोगों को भी वही आदत हो गई है टू डायग्नोज द डिसीज. मुझे ये है बताने में उनको बहुत अच्छा लगता है. I am having a thyroid, I am having a diabetes, I am having the pharyngitis. So वो एक suitable word में दूसरे को बोल सकते हैं. That's why they are interested in the name of the disease. Technically they are very sound because of this Google. So आपके पास भी patient कोई कोई अगर बहुत ज्यादा अच्छे cautious या अच्छे educated family से अगर आएगा, so directly he will give you the diagnosis. सब आपको अभी क्या करना है, सिर्फ common और uncommon symptoms आपको differentiate करने हैं. So don't believe on that Google guru patient. Please use your brain. The old Irishman walked into the clinic one day and after giving his symptoms said, "Doctor, what is the matter with me? Here he has given the good example of it. कि एक उनके पास person आता है, एक patient आता है, he will give the symptoms, वो पूछता है मुझे क्या हुआ है, अब मुझे डायग्नोज करो, सो दैट आई विल नो कि मेरा प्रोग्नोसिस क्या है. अल्टीमेटली वी नो वी वांट अ डायग्नोसिस फॉर द प्रोग्नोसिस, सो दैट पेशेंट आल्सो वांट अ डायग्नोसिस. द फिजिशियन आंसर वेरी स्मार्टली ही हैज आंसर, व्हाई यू हैव अ नसोमिका बीइंग हिज रेमेडी. तो उसने क्या किया, उसने उसको डायग्नोसिस नहीं दिया, उसने क्या किया, प्रिस्क्रिप्शन बताया कि यू आर अ नसोमिका पेशेंट, यू आर अ नसोमिका कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. Whereupon the old man said, well, I did think I had a wonderful disease or other. तो उसको समझ में नहीं आया. He said that कि मुझे अच्छा disease कुछ हुआ है क्या? Wonderful disease. That is an outgrowth of the old-fashioned polynemic sickness. So this is the result. कि allopathy वालों ने जो बीज बोया है diagnosis का, वो ऐसे अपने को reflect होता है. कि that person is having, oh, I have the nasomika. Except in the few acute diseases, no diagnosis can be made. No diagnosis need to be made except the patient is sick. कुछ कुछ इसमें जैसे ये patient आया था नक्सोमिका का, तो उसका diagnosis क्या होगा? Suppose नक्सोमिका के वो acute case है, तो उसको उसको symptoms क्या होंगे? Nausea होगा, vomiting होगा, loose motions होगा. इसको आप diagnosis क्या करोगे? Maybe gastritis or maybe the acidity. It may be the diarrhea. So ये diagnosis है क्या diarrhea? नहीं है. So sometimes we do not need to diagnose an acute disease, just treat that patient as a sick person. The one more thing of the name of the disease, so called, the one more be clouded in search of the remedy. For them, the disease is the only upon the result of disease and not upon the image expressed in the symptoms. So humko kahan pe concentrate karna hai? The image expressed in the form of symptoms. A patient 25 years age, with the gravest inheritance, with a 20 pages of symptoms, with her only symptom to furnish the image of sickness, is perfectly curable if treated in time. तो अगर आपको patient बहुत सारे symptoms दे रहा है, 20-30 pages आपको symptoms दे रहा है, but if they are all the common, फेंक दो उसको, हमको common की जरूरत नहीं है, सिर्फ उसमें से जो एक symptom which furnishes the image of sickness, जो एक characteristic रहेगा, that will be helpful you for the perfect cure. After being treated, there will be no pathological result. Life will go on the old age without the tissue destruction. So, आपको जो characteristic symptom मिलेंगे, वही आपको लेके वो pathological आपको treat करना है condition. लेकिन ये ध्यान में रखना है आपको, there should not be any tissue destruction while your treatment. But the patient is, if not cured at the early age, will take the disease result in accordance with the circumstances of his life and his inheritance. Agar aap waha pe treat nahi kar sake, then this result will jump into the palliation condition, and that palliation may lead to the inherited diseases, or this may lead to the suppression. If he is a chimney sweep, he will subject to the disease peculiar to the chimney sweeper. So we know from the pathology, aap ye log abhi padhoge systemic pathology mein, that is known as occupational diseases. So what are the occupational diseases? जहाँ पे आप काम कर रहे हो, your occupation के वजह से, if you are having the certain disturbances, if you are having the certain diseases because of the product of your occupation, then this is known as a occupational disease. For example, जैसे ये chimney sweeper का उन्होंने example दिया है. So chimney sweeper यानी क्या? Chimney आपको पता है कि जो एक outlet है फैक्ट्री में भी रहते हैं, और नाउ अडेज इट इज अवेलेबल इन अवर हाउसेस. सो वो क्या करते हैं कि जो डस्ट है या जो स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स है, वो दे आर द आउटलेट्स, सो दे विल थ्रो इट इन द एयर. सो वो चिमनी स्वीपर, वो चिमनी को भी हमको हमेशा साफ करना पड़ता है. सो तो वो क्या करेगा, वो जो ट्यूब्स है उसके, जो आउटलेट्स है, जो पाइप्स है, उसको वो साफ करने वाला, दैट इज अ चिमनी स्वीपर. अब उसको स्टिक क्या रहेंगे, जो स्मॉल, वेरी स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स ऑफ द डस्ट वहां पे स्टिक हो जाते हैं बाहर जाते जाते. तो अगर वो क्लीन कर रहा है एंड ही इज आल्सो टेकिंग द ऑक्सीजन, सो ड्यूरिंग हिज रेस्पिरेशन, ड्यूरिंग हिज इनहेलेशन, वो स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स इट विल एंटर इनटू हिज लंग एंड दिस मे कॉजेज द फाइब्रोसिस ऑफ लंग. तो उसको बोलते हैं ऑक्यूपेशनल डिजीजेस. दिस मे कॉजेज द निमोनिया, दिस मे कॉजेज अस्थमा. So, ये जो उसको रेस्पिरेटरी प्रॉब्लम होंगे, बिकॉज ऑफ हिज ऑक्यूपेशन, इट इज नोन एज ऑक्यूपेशनल डिजीजेस. सो वो चिमनी स्वीपर को अगर वो हो रहा है तो आप उसको कैसे ट्रीट करोगे? यू विल आस्क दैट पेशेंट टू लीव दैट जॉब फॉर सम टाइम, अगर पॉसिबल है तो जॉब ही चेंज कर, बिकॉज ही इज हैविंग द सर्टन हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम. इफ शी इज अ हाउसमेट, शी इज सब्जेक्ट टू डिजीज अ पिक्यूलियर टू द हाउसमेट, अगर वो झाड़ू और फर्शी कर रही है, सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट ही मे हैव द नी प्रॉब्लम, खड़े रहना बैठना ऑन हिज नीज ही इज हैविंग द प्रेशर. इफ इज अ हाउसमेट, अगर वो काम करिए किसी के घर में जाकर, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट दैट लेडी विल हैव द सिम्टम्स. सो आस्क दैट लेडी टू लीव दैट जॉब फॉर सम टाइम, शी विल बी बेटर. द पेशेंट हैज सम सेम डिजीज ही हैज बॉर्न. सो जैसे आप काम कर रहे हो, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट यू विल हैव द साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट यू विल हैव अ डिजीज. तो ये कंडीशन में आपको बहुत ज्यादा लिस्ट ऑफ मेडिसिन देने की जरूरत नहीं है, आपको सिर्फ कॉज उसका रिमूव करना है. द एरिया ऑफ सिम्टम रिप्रेजेंट द सेम स्टेट बिफोर द पैथोलॉजिकल कंडीशन हैज बीन फॉर्म देयर, सो एज आफ्टर. सो जैसा सो अपनी बॉडी अपने को पहले ही इंट्यूशन दे देती है कि इफ दैट पर्सन इज वर्किंग लाइक दिस देन दैट सर्टन पर्सन में दैट पर्सन में हैव द डिजीजेस लाइक दिस. सो सिर्फ आप कॉज रिमूव कर दो, दैट पेशेंट विल फील बेटर. And it is very true, if he has a liver disease or the brain disease or any other many tissue changes that they call disease, you must go back and procure these very symptoms before you can make a prescription. So, aap usko ye sab cause poocho and then you will do your prescription. Prescribing for the results of disease cause changes in the result of disease but not in the sickness except in the hurry progress. So, aap jaldi jaldi mein usko pneumonia ke drugs de doonge on the basis of result without any asking the cause. So, this is known as the hurry prescription. We will see the peculiarities running through the families. Kuch inherited diseases hote hai, jaise diabetes hai ya dusre bhi jo diseases hai, aise hi aaye hai. First they are the palliative and now they became inherited. In the beginning of the primary state which is present in only sign and symptoms. So, uski shuruaat kaisi hui? Only sign and symptoms. And the whole family needs the same remedy, a cognate of the remedy. But one member of the family, the condition runs into the cancer and the another into the thesis, but all the same common foundation. So, kabhi kabhi aisa bhi hota hai. डिरेंजमेंट ऑफ वाइटल फोर्स. तो प्राइमरी स्टेट में ही अगर आप ये साइन एंड सिम्टम्स उसके अच्छे से क्योर कर लोगे, सो इट ही विल नॉट गिव द इनहेरिटेड. तो इनहेरिटेंस वहां पे रुक जाएगा, दैट दूसरे जनरेशन को कैंसर भी नहीं होगा और तीसरे जनरेशन को ट्यूबरकुलोसिस भी नहीं होगा. सो दैट पैलिएशन सेपरेशन वहीं पे रुक जाएगा. दिस फंडामेंटल कंडीशन विच अंडरलाइज द डिजीज ऑफ द ह्यूमन रेस मस्ट बी अंडरस्टूड. सो अपने को ये समझना चाहिए कि द साइन एंड सिम्टम्स अगर प्रेजेंट है, सो ट्रीट दैट विदाउट नेम गिविंग सेरेमनी. विदाउट द नॉलेज ऑफ हिज विल, इम्पॉसिबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द एक्यूट मायज़ेमेटिक डिजीजेस विच विल बी अ कंसिडर लैटर. तो हमको पता है कि सूरा साइकोसिस सिफिलिस को कैसे हमको डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करना है अकॉर्डिंग टू द मेंटल सिम्टम्स. इट इज वेल नोन फैक्ट द सम पर्सन आर ससेप्टेबल टू वन थिंग. ये हमको पता है कि वी आर नॉट ससेप्टेबल टू ऑल द थिंग्स. डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द इम्यूनिटी वी आर शोइंग द डिसीज. इफ द एपिडेमिक कम अपॉन अ लैंड ओनली अ फ्यू कम डाउन विथ इट. सो हम ये भी हमको अभी पता है बिकॉज वी आर नाउ फेसिंग दिस स्टेज एपिडेमिक. जिसकी इम्यूनिटी कम है दे आर हैविंग द COVID-19, लेकिन जिसकी इम्यूनिटी मॉडरेट है या अच्छी है दे अभी हम लोग बचे हैं. एज सून एज जिसकी इम्यूनिटी कम हो जाएगी ही विल बी अ सफरर. व्हाई आर सम प्रोटेक्टेड एंड व्हाई दे आर नॉट, द थिंग्स मस्ट बी सेटल्ड बाय डॉक्टरिंग्स ऑफ होम्योपैथी. इडियोसिंक्रेसीज मस्ट बी अकाउंटेड फॉर. मेनी फिजिशियन वेस्ट देयर टाइम इन सर्चिंग आफ्टर द थिंग That make the patient sick. We know the idiosyncrasy. They are the oversensitive patient. उनको कुछ भी हो जाए तो they will show the symptoms. लेकिन allopathic physician उनको भी medicine देते हैं. The sick man will be a sick under every circumstance where the healthy man live in the lizard. अगर वो idiosyncratic है तो किसी भी छोटे से इसमें he will become a sick. लेकिन वो healthy है, उसकी immunity अच्छी है, तो कोई भी situation हो जाए he will be a healthy. It is not the principal business of the physician to be hunting into the rivers and the sailors and examining the food we eat for the cause of the disease. So this is more important line. So हमारी duty क्या है? Our duty is not to get the money. हमको कुछ hunt नहीं करना है वो सोना चांदी वो river में से. हमको क्या चाहिए उसमें से? सिर्फ characteristic symptom. Unnecessary patient को immunity low करना, unnecessary palliation करना, this is not our duty. It is the duty to burn out the symptom of the sickness until the remedy found covers the disorder. This is our duty. हमको वो उसमें से pathology उसमें से disease हमको find out नहीं करनी है. हमको अच्छे से remedy find out करनी है कि जो वो sick person को treat करे, उसका restore करे health. That remedy which will be produced on the healthy man similar symptom, it is the master of the situation. It is necessary antidote will overcome the sickness, restore will and understanding. To order to cure the patient. This is our duty. कि उसका will, उसका understanding हमको restore करना है. उसको you can give the similar medicine and do this to get the real nature of human economy to lead up to the sickness upon opens out the field for the investigation in the more scientific way. So आपको human economy को treat करना है. आपको sickness को treat करना है by using the more scientific way. The sickness can be learned by the study of the proving of the drug upon the healthy economy. Hahnemann made use of this information and thus obtained he started that the man is the key to the man. So पहले हमने देखा तीन points में ये chapter divide किया है. First we have seen how the viewpoint of disease according to the disease का viewpoint कैसा है homeopathic का and allopathic का. Second we have seen the treatment part. What they require for the treatment, what we are required for the treatment. Third point is now we are discussing here about the proving. How they are proving, how we are proving. So we are proving the drugs on the healthy economy because we know the reasons from the first year pharmacy and that is only the key to understand the symptoms of the patient. The symptoms of the mind have been found to the followers to be the most important symptom in the remedy and in the sickness because the man is consists of what he thinks, what he loves, nothing else. So मैंने पहले भी आपको बताया है कि will understanding यानी उसकी thinking और love these are the more important. If these two grand parts of the man will and understanding are separated, या उसको कुछ इच्छा ही नहीं रही और उसका कुछ भी understanding नहीं है तो इसका नतीजा क्या होगा सुशांत सिंह. That is nothing but the insanity. That is nothing but the disorder. That is nothing but the death. So this is the result of the loss of will and understanding. And this is the three words will indicate your Sushant Singh: insanity, disorder, and death. All medicines operate upon the will and understanding first, because we are doing the potentization. We are giving the potentized medicine. This potentized medicine will act dynamically on your will, understanding your vital force, and it will restore the health. So, with a proved drug in the materia medica, we have them. So, in the materia medica, actually drugs hai, they are all proved on the healthy human beings, and that's why we are unique on of doing the drug proving on the healthy human being. We see them affecting the man's mind and proceeding from mind to the physical economy to the outermost to the skin, the hair, senses. So, हमारी medicine कहाँ पे act कर रही है पहले mind पे and then to the physical economy that is the skin, hair, senses. If the medicine are thus studied, you will have no knowledge of them. You can carry with you the materia medica is established upon this basis. So, you are carrying your materia medica with you. You can observe your materia medica by observing the world of people. That means that कोई patient नक्सोमिका का है, कोई arsenic का है, कोई pulsatilla patient है. So they are all the materia medicas in front of you. कब? When you are studying that patient from his mind to the pathology. मैंने पहले आपको तीन point बताया है कि Kant ने philosophy कैसे define की है. So from mind. Physical journals and then to the pathological journal. The sickness must be therefore to be examined through the scrutiny of elements that make up the morbid changes that exist the likeliness of the drug substances. to the extent that drug is proving upon the healthy man have brought out the symptoms on animal ultimates, must we study the sickness with the hope of adjusting remedies to the sickness in the man under the law of similar. So humko pata hai what are the benefits of doing the drug proving on the healthy man, not on the sick man and not on the animals. We studied it in the first year pharmacy. Ultimates results, function symptoms, sensorial symptoms, mind symptoms are useful and none could be overlooked. So वही फिर से इन्होंने यहाँ पे दिया है डॉक्टर केंट ने, because he is more interested in the mental symptoms, so he has given the more importance to the sensorial symptom, to the function symptoms, to the ultimate symptoms and the mind symptoms. The idea of sickness in the man must be formed from the idea of sickness perceived in our materia medica. अगर आप अच्छे से study करोगे materia medica, so you will know कि this is a kalika patient, this is a naksomika patient, this is the pulsatilla patient. क्यों? क्योंकि हमने drug healthy human being पे ही prove किए. As we perceive the nature of sickness in a drug image, so we must perceive the nature of sickness in the human beings. Have to be healed. ह्यूमन बींग को ही ट्रीट करना है तो ह्यूमन बींग का ही ड्रग प्रूविंग करो. यू विल मैच योर सिम्टम्स वेरी इजीली. देयर फोर अवर आइडिया ऑफ पैथोलॉजी मस्ट बी एडजस्टेड टू सच अ मटेरिया मेडिका एज वी पजेस एंड इट मस्ट बी डिस्कवर्ड वेयर इन देयर आर द सिमिलर इन ऑर्डर टू सीक द हील. सो आपकी पैथोलॉजी जो है इट इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द इंटीरियर मैन. आपकी पैथोलॉजी विल एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग पे डिपेंड है. आपका मटेरिया मेडिका ह्यूमन बींग के ड्रग प्रूविंग के इस पर डिपेंड है. सो क्यों ये सब है? बिकॉज यू वॉन्ट टू ट्रीट द सिक पर्सन. यू डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू ट्रीट द अल्टीमेट्स. यू वॉन्ट टू रिस्टोर द हेल्थ. सो इट इज वेरी इजी फॉर अस टू कंपेयर ऑन द मटेरिया मेडिका एंड अवर पेशेंट. द टोटैलिटी ऑफ द सिम्टम रिटर्न आउट केयरफुली is all we know the internal nature of the sickness. We know the importance of totality of the symptoms. Agar aapki totality achhe se bani hai, so you will know the internal nature of the sickness. Then the proper administration of the similar remedy will constitute the art of healing. So agar aapki ye medicine achhi hai, then the art of healing aapka ho jayega, because the homeopathy is a science and art. आपको साइंस का नॉलेज है. व्हेन यू आर अप्लाइंग दैट साइंस दिस लॉज ऑन द पेशेंट फॉर हिज हीलिंग देन डील बिकेम अ आर्ट ऑफ हीलिंग. ओके, सो अगर आप अच्छे से साइंस या कार्डिनल प्रिंसिपल्स आप वो पेशेंट पे अप्लाई कर रहे हो, दैट विल बिकेम योर आर्ट ऑफ हीलिंग. सो दिस इज अबाउट द सिक अकॉर्डिंग टू द केयर. सो दिस इज डिवाइडेड इन टू द view of the cause of the disease according to the homeopathy and allopathy. Second, the importance of diagnosis according to them and according to the homeopathy. Third, the treatment of the disease. And the fourth, the proving of the medicines. So in these 3 to 4 points, this whole chapter is divided. They are giving more importance to the bacteria, that is the cause of the disease. We are giving the more importance to the vital force. We are accepting the doctrine of vital force. We are accepting the internal man, that is deranged first, and then it is proceed forward. So the man come first and then his organ. The internal man come first, the life is come first, then the body. These are the viewpoint of the Kane on the basis of the first aphorism. And what is our duty? Our duty is to treat that internal man. Ultimately, the disease will treat. The ultimates of the disease should not be our aim to treat the disease, but to treat the vital force, to treat that internal man. This is our sole aim, the sole duty. So what is your duty now? You have to answer me the 2 questions. The 3 points which are important in the mental symptoms given by Dr. Kane. And the second question is that where you will read the body language, or you can read the faces of that people very clearly. Before आप कर सकते थे और after आप लोग करेंगे तो आप face reading अच्छे से कर सकते हो. So these are my 2 questions. Give the answer and take the attendance. Clear? If you have any query, let me know, read this chapter again and again and make the notes. मैंने आपको notes दिए हैं, लेकिन अगर आप अपनी भी notes इसमें अगर prepare करोगे, so that will be a better. Okay? Thank you.